गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल हैव कंप्लीटेड योर चैप्टर नंबर 1 दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज पॉलीनोमियल्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स? पॉलीनोमियल्स आई हैव रिटन द डेफिनेशन हियर. अ पॉलीनोमियल px, इट कैन बी py, इट कैन बी pz. x इज ओनली द वेरिएबल ओनली. Which x is telling us that the polynomial is in x variable. In variable x, px is equals to an x power n, an minus 1 x power n, and so on, and the last is a0. Where a1, a2, a3, these all are the constants. And we can also say that they are coefficients of, they are coefficients of x size. They are the coefficients of x size. Why we have written here an should not equal to 0? This one is the important one. Why we have written here an should not equals to 0? Because if an will be equals to 0, then the degree of the polynomial, then this complete term will become 0. And the degree of the polynomial will be n minus 1. So at that time the degree will be reduced. It means if I am writing a cubic polynomial, degree is 3 plus x square. But if I will write here 0, means the coefficient of x cube is 0, then this term will be vanished and it will turn to x square. And now the cubic polynomial is turned to a quadratic polynomial. So this is not possible. So that's why the coefficient of the highest degree should not equals to 0 whenever we want to define the polynomial. So a polynomial of one term is called a monomial. Students, we are going to divide the polynomials into two bases. First one in regarding the terms. How many terms are there? Second is regarding the degrees. First, what is the meaning of term? See, one term, two term, and next, these are the terms. When we are using plus and minus sign to defining the variables and the terms, they are known as the terms. Like if I will write 3x plus 3y, I have written here different variable. So 3x plus 3y, one term, and this is two term. So here are how many terms are there? Two terms are there. So terms means how many terms the polynomial is divided in, how many terms. And the second is in the degree. Degree means what is the degree of the polynomial. So the types of the polynomial can be considered regarding the terms and regarding the degrees. If one term will be there, like 3x is there, only one term, then it is known as the monomial. Then this will be known as the monomial. If two terms are there, 3x square plus 2x. If two terms are there, then it is known as binomial. Then it is known as binomial. If we are having three terms, one more is there, that is, let it be constant. Then they are known as trinomial. Then these polynomials are known as trinomial. So if one term is there, monomial. Two term is there, binomial. Three term is there, trinomial. Now the question can be like this. Can we say that 3, 4, 2, 3 and the second number is 4 and the 2 or some other numbers also, they are also the polynomials? I said monomial is 3x. Can I say this is also a monomial, 7 number? So the answer is yes. 7 is also a monomial because 7 can be written as 7. Can be written as 7 is equals to 7x power 0. Because we all know that x power 0 is always equals to 1. So all the numbers plus, minus or in the fraction, all types of numbers can be written in the polynomial form. By adding the x and multiply any number by 1, it will not affect the answer and the number. So 7, 8, these are also the example of the monomials. Now, what about 0? What about 0? is 0 also a monomial? First of all, tell me, is 0 a polynomial? Yes, 0 is also a polynomial, but the condition of the polynomial is an should not equal to b0, the coefficient should not equal to b0. Here 7 is a coefficient of x power 0 and 7 is not equal to 0. That's why we have considered it as a polynomial. But if I will write 0 into x power 0, then here the coefficient is not equal to 0. It is already 0. Then what about x power z? This 0? 0 is a special type of polynomial and the name of this polynomial is 0 polynomial. The name of this polynomial is 0 polynomial. So that's why we are considering this examples also. The next point is a polynomial. Now, again the division of the polynomial on the behalf of their degrees. If the degree of the polynomial is 1, if I am writing like 3x, or it can be 3x plus 7. It can be 3x plus 7 or 8 or any other number. Here, the degree of the polynomial is 1. Nothing is there, then 1 is there. Nothing is there, then 1 is there. So, if the degree of the polynomial is 1, then the polynomial is known as the linear polynomial. Then the polynomial is known as the linear polynomial. Second is, if a polynomial with degree 2, if we are having a polynomial, first example, now second example, and then is third example. Degree 2. So if a polynomial with degree 2 is known as the quadratic polynomial, why I have given these three different examples? Because here I just have taken one term. So if degree 2, it doesn't mean that there should be 3x also or plus the third term also. This is a quadratic polynomial. If third term the constant is missing, still it is a quadratic polynomial. Next is 3x square plus 7. It is also a quadratic polynomial because for defining the quadratic polynomial, we are considering the powers. So here degree is 2, degree 2, degree 2. It means this is a quadratic polynomial. If you will again want to divide this polynomial according to the terms, then this is one term monomial, two terms binomial, two terms binomial. Fine, class. So next is a polynomial of degree 3 is called a cubic polynomial. If we are having degree 3, 3x cube plus 7x square plus 4x plus 5, or we are having more terms also here. So, if the degree of the polynomial is 3, this is all about this degree, then the polynomial is known as cubic polynomial. The next is a real number. A is 0 of a polynomial. If it means we can take any real number. Real number is a set of rational numbers and irrational number. So if we are having a real number and you will put like if I will put minus 3 in this polynomial, minus 3 means the value of x is equals to minus 3. If I will put in this polynomial, then if the answer turned to 0, then that number, that minus 3 will be the 0 of the given polynomial. Let me explain you through one example. If I am having a polynomial x plus 3, the polynomial is x plus 3. Now put x is equals to minus 3. So p minus 3 is equal to minus 3 plus 3. The answer is 0. It means when the answer will turn to 0, it means minus 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. Next is, what about the remainder theorem? We are having two theorems in this chapter, remainder theorem and the second one is factor theorem. Remainder theorem and factor theorem. So, if we are having any polynomial, you can take any polynomial. Let me take the polynomial x minus 3. If, or we can say x minus x square minus something else. And if you want to, if a polynomial is divided by x minus a, then the remainder is pa. Then remainder pa means we will put x minus 1 is equal to 0, then what is the value of x? 1. Now put x is equal to 1 in this polynomial, then p1 is equal to 1 minus 3, that is minus 2. This minus 2 will be the remainder of the polynomial. Here we have just substituted the value x is equal to minus 3 and 0 came here. Then 0 is the remainder of the polynomial. 0 is the remainder of the polynomial. As the answer turned to 0, so it is the 0 of the polynomial. 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. Can also be say like this. 3 minus 3 is the root of the polynomial. Is the root of the polynomial. Last is factor theorem. If you x minus a is a factor of the polynomial, then pa is equal to 0. This is all about same like this. If you are having any polynomial px, px is equal to x square plus x minus 4. If you are putting any value of x here and the answer turned to 0, it means this is the remainder. Or if you are putting x minus a, if you are writing x minus a is a factor, if x minus a is a factor, it means when you will put x minus a is equals to 0 and the value of x will be a. When you will put x is equal to a in the main polynomial, the answer will 100% turn to 0. So this is all about the factor theorem. What is the meaning of factor theorem? When you will put the value, it means the answer should be equals to 0. Fine. For more detail, we will take the examples of the same and we will discuss in our next class. So this is all about the polynomial only. In the next class, we will take examples and we will discuss about this. So first, let me tell you again about the monomial, binomial and trinomial. Monomial, one term. Binomial, two term. Trinomial, three term. Linear, quadratic, cubic. Linear, one degree one. Cubic, degree three. And quadratic, degree two. Next is remainder theorem and factor theorem. When you will put the value, the answer that you are getting is known as the remainder. If the expression is a factor, then you can put the value of the variable and it will turn to 0. So this is all about today's class. We will discuss more in the next class. Fine, student. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.